This is Srinivas Lakyam. Today we are going to discuss ls command. We use ls command for to list files and directories. In Windows, when you click on any partition or drive, we will see list of files and directories, right? The same way, if you want to know what are the files and directories presented in particular file system, we use ls command. Okay, let's see practically. So there is a command called ls. So this ls command lists files and directories. See here, these are list of files and directories presented in current working directory. Do you know what is current working directory? How do we find current working directory? By using pwd command. So currently we are in user home directory, root user home directory. See, this ls command gives list of files and directories of current working directory. If you want to display specified directory or specified file system location, files and directories, for that one we use ls space. I want to display what are the files and directories presented under slash opt directory. So if you give specific path, it gives list and files, list of files and directories of that directory. So current working directory contain these files and directories. This class opt contain these files and directories. So if you give ls command, it displays current working directory, files and directories. If you use specific path, it displays list of files and directories of specified path. Okay, there is one more command, ls space -a. You can use either capital A or lowercase a. This ls space -a option, for ls command we can pass some options. In that we are going to see some important options. So first option is -a. If you pass -a, it lists files and directories, plus hidden files. See, if any file's name start with dot, this file is called hidden file. If you want to know what are the hidden files presented in a current working directory, or if you want to know what are the hidden files presented in specified location, then we use command called ls space -a. Okay, see, I want to display files and directories. Here we are seeing list of files and directories, but I want to display files and directories with comma separation operator. We use option called ls space -m. If you use this option, it gives list of files and directories with comma separation value. So each file or directory is separated with comma. Okay, if you want to display any files, we are using ls command, right? Observe here, ls command displaying list of files and directories in ascending order. I want to display list of files and directories in descending order. Simply recently create, descending order. We use ls-r. It displays list of files and directories in descending order. Okay, if you want to display list of files and directories based on time, then we use ls space -t. So it displays based on time. See, I am creating new file cat > test, and I am entering some data. I am saving this file. Again I am running ls -t. ls-t. See here, test is created recently, right? So it is shown as first one. Okay. If you want to display files and directories with their size, if you want to display files and directories with their size, we use ls-s. See, files has size, but directories doesn't have size, right? So directory contain files and subdirectories. We cannot find size of directory. So this is a file. This file has 4. What is this 4? Is this 4 is number of bytes or number of KBs or number of MBs? So by seeing number, we cannot say this is number of bytes, this is number of kilobytes, this is number of megabytes, right? So we want to print sizes in human readable format. We want to print sizes in human readable format. For that one, we use option called ls-s-h. See here, now we are seeing what? So abc.jar contain 4 KB. This demo.jar contain 4 KB. 4 KB, 4 KB. Like this, we can see sizes in human readable format. Okay. Next, there is very important command ls-l. ls-l. L stands for long list. It displays list of files and directories in long list format with fields. Long list format, sorry, long list format with fields. See, sorry. So this is listing all files and directories in long list form. In this long list form, it has 8 fields. It has 8 fields. Let's discuss here. ls-l list files and directories in long list form in fields. So this is, it's giving this information, right? So what are these fields? So first field is file type. File type. By seeing this file type, we can say whether this is file or not. By seeing this file type, we can say whether this is file or not. Some people say, by seeing this color code, we can identify file or directory. But by seeing color, we cannot identify whether this is a file or not. Okay? By seeing file type only, we can say whether this is file or not. So here, this is file type. So this is what? File type. This is file type. If it is if it is hyphen. If it is hyphen, then we can say, it is file. We can say it is file. If it is D, then we can say, it is directory. Let's open again a terminal. See, you are seeing hyphen for ABC, right? This is file. You are seeing hyphen for anaconda hyphen ks.cfg, right? This is file. You are seeing hyphen for demo.jar, right? This is file. You are seeing D for desktop, right? This is directory. You are seeing D for directory 1, right? So this is directory. If you see hyphen means it is a file. If you see D means it is a directory. Okay. Next important field, second field. File permissions. These three fields are file permissions. Okay, next we will discuss in depth about what are permissions in next session. We will discuss what is this permission, what is this representation. First of all, we want to know what is this representation. This is for owner. These three characters is for owner. These three characters is for group members. These three characters is for other members. Okay, we will discuss what are these permissions in next session in depth. Okay, next important field is number of links. So if you create a file, internally it will create links. We will discuss what is links in some other session. Okay, so this is number of links. Next one, owner of file. This is owner. Next one, group of file. Whether this directory belongs to which group? Group of file. So this is group. And next, this is date. Date and time. So next field is date. Next important field is file name. Next important field is file name. And next one more, observe here. This is file size. This is date and time. This is file size. File size. seventh one is file, sixth one is file size. File size. And seventh one is date. And eighth one is file name. Eighth one is file name. This is file name. File name or directory name. File name or directory name. So these are eight fields. Okay. So by seeing file type only, we can say whether this is file or directory. Okay. These file eight fields, it gives these eight fields when we type ls-l. Okay. So recently they modified this ls-l with ll. If you use ll also, it gives same information. Ll command means long list, long list. Okay. And in real time we use most used command is ls space hyphen la, ls hyphen l t r. What is l? Long list, right? What is t? Time based, right? What is r? Descending order, right? So it displays long list in time based in reverse order. It means it's simply we are getting recently created files. Okay. Yep. Thank you.